I want to understand from you, Dr. Valia, what is the starting point? How does one navigate this journey from symptoms to diagnosis?
So the starting point is not only the first symptom. The starting point is awareness about the disease, how the disease can present. And the starting point is also awareness about the prevention of the disease and the screening about the disease. But in our country, we are still struggling. What to say of screening? We are still struggling to tell them that these are the symptoms, at least, I mean, one needs to be aware of what prevents breast cancer. One needs to be aware of how we can pick it up early, what we need to do even before the symptoms develop. But at least when the symptoms develop, then please, please, please don't take it as a taboo. Talk to people. Talk to somebody in the family. Go and show to your family doctor at least.
Is there a need for that much fear to be there when people come to know that they have breast cancer? Dr. Govind, if you can just explain to us why this fear exists today.
Cancer, we always used to call it as Big C, no? And when they say cancer, it was considered a death sentence. This was the days when I started oncology. In fact, the stigma was not just for cancer. It was not just for patients. People ask me, why are you going into oncology? Even the doctors would get stigmatized. So that was the situation. But today we know that patients are living much longer. Many cancers are getting cured, including breast cancer. The main point is to detect breast cancer early, because then if you detect them early, their lifespan could be as normal as a person who did not have cancer. So this is very, very important to remember. It is not education. It is not how rich you are that you get the detection done early and take treatment. So I think the unique thing in our Indian society is that the woman puts herself behind the rest of the family. So I think that is not the thing that they should do.
We are very fortunate in our country to have best of the international standardized protocols being followed at all the major institutions. We are capable and we are actually giving the best of the treatment which is available for the patient. But then the gap lies in sometimes it is the real ignorance. Sometimes it is the real logistic problems. But sometimes sometimes it is none of them. It is just the attitude. It is just the attitude, because we Indians sometimes tend to feel as that health is something. We never plan for our health.
So I think, Ignore, you mentioned about PET scan waiting period is 3 months. That is in the US, not in India. In India,
a couple of years ago in India as well.
No. I think you went to the wrong place. In fact, there is hardly any waiting. In fact, patients should feel happy that there is no waiting list here. In India, they can just walk into any doctor's chamber and they will be seen. Unlike in the US, where they have to wait for 6 months to get an appointment.
So I think that's a myth. I'm glad that you've busted here. These are myths that exist, right? Outside,
exactly.
When people talk about it, that, oh my God,
yes.
We'll not be able to get tested.
Absolutely.
There is a waiting. So
yeah.
I'm really glad
Correct.
That you did.
The first person a patient will go to is a pharmacist. And, you know, many times that pharmacy is not manned by a qualified pharmacist also. He would have left a person who is, you know, who knows nothing. And he will send that patient, he will give whatever medicine he has. And if he doesn't get better, he will send him to a non-qualified quack. But I think programs like this are slowly picking up. People are getting aware. I think today, everybody in India have access to social media, TV. So I think the awareness is definitely there.